is the hour of memory, and this is our house of comfort. Wounded by loss, we retreat from life. Our synagogue gathers us in. Into this place, we bring stories and prayers, unanswered questions, tears that need to be shed, lives recollected and carried within us, moments of courage and laughter and pain. This day embraces them all. This place embraces them all. Now the heart opens in sorrow, for we are time's subjects, and all that we love, we must lose. So let us hold fast to the love that remains and cherish the light of the sun. Today, all of us walk the mourner's path. Together, may we find strength. Page 544.
Sodek in yods
They alone are left me, they alone still faithful, for now death can do no more to them.
במפנה הדרך בערוב היום, יקיפוני חרש, ילבוני דום.
At the bend of the road, at the close of the day, they gather around me silently and walk by my side.
ברית אמת היא לנו, קשר לא נפרד, רק אשר אבד לי, קנייני לעד.
This is a bond nothing can ever loosen, but I have lost what I possess forever.
555. Adonai, Ben Enosh, Ben Enosh, Vatechashavu.
How hard to fathom that we are worthy of your care. How astonishing your awareness of us. For we are like the morning mist, our days a passing shadow. At dawn we flourish anew, by dusk we wither and fade. Sending us back to earth's dust, you tell us, return, you who belong to humanity. If only we were wise and understood what lies ahead. For when we die, we carry nothing away. We leave our possessions behind. So mark the wholehearted, take note of the upright, for there is purpose in a life of integrity. Adonai, you replenish the lives of all who revere you, and those who trust in you will never despair. From the prison of my grief I called you, and you led me to open spaces. Happy is the one who draws strength from God, whose heart is on a path to you. Send forth your light and your truth, they will guide me.
Yes, I know. Is it real?
turn my eyes to the mountains, from where will my help come? My help comes from the eternal, maker of heaven and earth. God will not let your foot give way, your guardian will not slumber. See, the guardian of Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. The eternal is your guardian, the eternal is your protection at your right hand. By day the sun will not strike you, nor the moon by night. The eternal will guard you from all harm. God will guard your soul. The eternal will guard your going and coming now and forever. Page 559. In my darkness, be a light to me. In my loneliness, help me to find a soul akin to my own. Give me strength to live with courage. Give me courage to draw blessing from life. Even in the midst of suffering, to hold fast against the storm and to smile at a loved one's glance. 561. When I cry, my voice trembles with fear. When I call out, it cracks with anger. How can I greet the dawn with song when darkness eclipses the rising sun? To whom shall I turn when the clouds of the present eclipse the rays of tomorrow? Turn me around to yesterday that I may be consoled by its memories. Were not the seas split asunder? Did we not once walk together through the waters to the dry side? Did we not bless the bread that came forth from the heavens? Did your voice not reach my ears and direct my wanderings? The waters, the lightning, the thunder remind me of yesterday's triumphs. Let the past offer proof of tomorrow. Let it be my comforter and guarantor. I've been here before, known the fright and found your companionship. I enter the sanctuary again to await the echo of your promise. 562.
Haneshama halach vehaguf polach chusa. Haneshama halach vehaguf polach chusa chusa alam halach. Haneshama halach vehaguf polach chusa.
And pages 568 through 578, we have the Yizkor prayers, specific prayers for those whom we have lost. Please take a few moments and pray the Yizkor prayer for all of your loved ones.
up above. So far away, we only see their light. Long, long after the star itself is gone. And so it is with people that we loved. Their memories keep shining, ever brightly, though their time with us is done. But the stars that light up the darkest night, these are the lights that guide us as we live. שאורם מגיע ארצה רק אשר הם עצמם עבדו ואינם יש אנשים שזיו זכרם מאיר כאשר הם עצמם אינם עוד בתוכנו אורות אלה חשקת הלילה הם הם שמראים לאדם את הדרך את הדרך הם הם שמראים לאדם את הדרך את הדרך as we live
Page 579. Adonai, through all generations, we have found our home in you. Before the mountains rose up, before the birth pangs of the earth, you alone have been with us, steadfast and constant for all time. In the end, you return us to dust, saying, come home now, daughters and sons of Adam and Eve, you are mortal. In your sight, 1,000 years pass in an instant, like a fleeting watch in the night. But how brief the span of our lives. Our years flow by in a dream. We sleep away our days. In the morning, we blossom in beauty. In the evening, we wither away. Burnt like grass in the blasting heat of summer, we perish like chaff on the wind. A human life may be 70 years, or 80 years for those who are blessed with strength. So many days consumed by toil and troubles, then our time is cut short. Too soon we go into the dark. So teach us to number our days, that we may bring home a heart of wisdom. Give us a sense of your presence. Nourish us with your compassion. Knowing your love at the dawn of our life, let us live our days in contentment. May our moments of joy surpass the times of struggle. May we taste the sweetness of each precious day. May the work of our hands bring fulfillment. Page 594.
He leadeth me
our speaker, Lana Teredash-Shiner, who will help us think about grief and loss through her own experiences.
Thank you, Rabbi and Cantor, for inviting me today to share of my own experiences. And I'm a little nervous, but I hope that you'll find it helpful in some way. I was 4 years old, eating lunch at McDonald's, when I saw my grandmother, Mama Jean, ascend to heaven. She was laying down with her eyes closed, her white hair perfectly styled, wearing a tweed skirt suit, clasping the handle of her pocketbook in her lap as she was supported by the light blue sky around her. She was slowly carried towards the clouds, through the clouds, further and further away until I could no longer see her. I know this might sound totally crazy to some of you, and it actually does make me laugh as I think about my four-year-old self watching Mama Jean float to heaven as I was eating a Happy Meal. And I don't remember much else about Mama Jean. I have always wished she was here to tell me about her family's immigration to America from Russia when she was two, her days as a professional violinist in the First Nashville Symphony, and what my dad was like as a little boy. But I do remember this vision I had of Mama Jean with total clarity. Was it a dream? Was it something I concocted in my four-year-old mind? I have no recollection of where that moment was on the timeline of her passing, but it has brought me peace. My whole life believing that there is something more, something else past our existence here. Perhaps this is precipitated through those Hollywood endings where heaven exists, with the pearly white gates and the fluffy clouds as they open to reunite us again with our loved ones. This actually is not an experience that I have ever shared before. In fact, I don't even know if my husband over there knows. But I am sharing with you Yom Kippur at this time of reflection. And I encourage you to always listen to the words of others with a kind ear, because we do have the right to explore our own beliefs with grief, whether privately or publicly. On May 13th of this year, my husband Adam and I had the honor of seeing our middle child, Amelia, become a bat mitzvah right here at Temple B'nai Or. It was a day that we had planned for years, as these dates are assigned so far in advance. This date I couldn't wait for would suddenly become a date I would equally face with dread. On May 13th, 2022, exactly 1 year before Amelia's bat mitzvah, I lost my father, Howard Teredash. As I muddled my way through my sadness and realized that his first yahrzeit would be the day of my daughter's bat mitzvah, my first thought was, well, we have to change the date. How could we celebrate Amelia's incredible Jewish milestone on the same day that I lost my father? That thought was fleeting, as I do believe that there are no coincidences in life. And what better way to honor my father's memory than having all of our family together at Temple, carrying on his Jewish legacy as well. It was a full circle moment, celebrating Amelia's passage to adulthood in the Jewish community and the memory of my father all at once. And this brought a tremendous amount of healing to my family that we really desperately needed. My father had an incredible fear of being forgotten. See, Dad, we remember and you made sure of it, I am sure. If I had to choose a relationship status for my father and I, it would read, "It's complicated." The father I had before he went into memory care was far different than the father I had the 44 years before. When my dad spoke of his own father, who died when I was 4 months old, he told me, "Papa Nathan was the best father he knew how to be." And those are the same words that resonate with me today when I think about my dad. He was the best father he knew how to be. My dad's anger and impulsivity often got the best of him. And we sometimes suffered as a result. There was another side of him that was remarkably introspective and loving. My grieving process with my father was very front-loaded. His diagnosis with dementia and those last 2 years of his life really were the long goodbye. When my father, who marched to the beat of his own drum his whole life, and often with little apology, went into memory care, we all thought it would be a total disaster. We thought for sure he was going to get kicked out for his sometimes aggressive behavior or belligerent demeanor. But he didn't. Much to our complete disbelief, his experience in memory care was the complete opposite. He was everyone's favorite resident. My dad was a lawyer and a judge, and they called him the judge. He found peace there. His life was simplified, confined to just one small room with his favorite Tennessee Titans and Nashville Predators paraphernalia collection, his Mickey Mouse paraphernalia as well, and photographs of us, and long frequent visits by family and friends who he loved more than anything. He always told me I was the best thing that ever happened to him. And I believe him. I can still hear his words. His last years, he became a calmer, gentler version of himself. My father was reflective and loving and full of regret. He was so full of regret. I could feel it. I could hear it. And he said it without even saying it. And he was so afraid to die. I regret feeling too vulnerable to tell my father of my vision of his mother, Mama Jean. I know it would have brought him a lot of comfort. Every time he said goodbye to me when I would visit him in Nashville, he didn't want to let me go. He would just well up with tears and used to make me promise that I would take care of my mom. And I always assured him that I would. And we do, as we are now alongside my mother on her journey with Alzheimer's and experiencing another long goodbye, trying to find the way to navigate through this grieving process with as little regret as possible. So music was extremely therapeutic to my dad in his final months. He constantly had Frank Sinatra on repeat in his room. Even when his memory was declining, he never forgot us. And that was such a gift. And he also didn't forget a single word to those Frank songs. On May 13, 2022, I flew into Nashville early in the morning and went straight to see my dad. He was dying. I had gotten that call. And this was it. It was happening. And I knew that he was waiting for me. Frank was on. It was the soundtrack that drifted him off into his next chapter. And we were all there. My mom, my sister, my brother, my nephew Joseph. Exactly how he would have wanted it. And let me tell you something. It was a Hollywood ending. We'd all been sitting by my dad's bedside all day. The nurses encouraged us to get something to eat because she assured us it was going to be a while. Definitely hours, maybe days. My sister wanted her time alone with him. So the rest of us went to eat nearby, even though, of course, we didn't feel like it. We were paying the bill when my sister Robin called, not even an hour later. We needed to come right away. It was time. We went to his room, and we held him physically as he shook and rattled and gasped. He opened his eyes for the first time all day and looked at us. I mean, each of us, one by one, with total clarity. We were there together, and he knew it. He closed his eyes. We told him it was okay to go. He would be with his parents, maybe, Mama Jean and Papa Nathan, whom he'd missed so deeply and talked about missing in his final months. And off he went. Sinatra's iconic My Way was playing in the background. And isn't that funny? That's kind of funny. And it really was playing. And there's no other song that could have been more fitting for my father's final chapter in this life. The haunting lyrics, which I'm sure you all know, and now the end is near, and so I face that final curtain, and the verse then goes on to end with, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. I did not see my father ascend to heaven that day, but I did look out the window just to make sure. But here's my comfort as I grieve and I miss my father. I imagine my dad arriving to heaven just in time for the height of happy hour, following his 6:03 p.m. passing on Friday, May 13th, with his barreling laugh and tear-filled eyes, saying his famous phrase, "Golly," as he's reunited with his loved ones, past toasting over a scotch with a splash of water. So, now what do we all do here now? When our loved ones are no longer with us, when there are no more chances to ask the questions we were too scared or proud to ask during these living years, how do we live the rest of our lives grieving what was and what could have been? We must allow ourselves grace and patience, the time to go through the gamut of emotions, turn to those we need, and shy away from those that we don't. Whatever we need our own truth and beliefs of life and death to be, to find peace that we need to go on, no matter how far-fetched they may seem. Please let it be without apology. Your grieving process is yours to discover and make meaning of. It will always evolve. Grieve with the comfort knowing that you did it your way.
These are the names of those we've lost since last year, Yom Kippur. Malcolm Bush, Lisa Bush, B. Mark Cohen, Alan Fields, Mary Jo Glazer, Bruce Goldman, Gloria Gould, Charles Homwe, Sheila Carner, Ronald Edward Lemonson, Elaine Markell, Harold Moffitt, Paul Mosco, Mark Moskowitz, Ken Ottinger, Paul Olson, Ruth Pallas, Calvin Ring, Sheila Rich, Lawrence Ross, Oscar Schatcher, Bernice Side, Alan Silverstein, Glenn Swatinsky, Marilyn Mitzi Serlip, Patricia Tolkoff, Barbara Treshak, Andrew Ward, and Svia Yisachar. Amalei Rachamim is on page 598. Please rise.
Shochen b'merumim Ha'matzim Menucho nechono Tachat Kanfe ha'shchino Yastirem beseter kenafav olamim vitzrul vitzrul achaim et nishmatum Adonai Shalom al mishkavam venomar
Merciful God, God Most High, let there be perfect rest for the souls of our loved ones who have gone into eternity. May they find shelter in your presence among the holy and pure, whose light shines like the radiance of heaven. Compassionate God, hold them close to you forever. May their souls be bound up in the bond of life eternal. May they find a home in you. May they rest in peace. And together we say, Amen. Amen. On page 603, the words of our rabbi, Donald Rossoff. If every life were like a drop of rain, each of us a small, solitary self, then death would be for us return back to the ocean whence we came. Some raindrops soft and gentle as the showers of spring, others hard and raging like summer storms of hail and thunder. Each life a separate journey back to the beginning and back to God. Picture God as a great ocean, teeming with life in the ebb tide and flow, where each raindrop begins and ends and begins again and again. In the dance of waves, we dance forever, not I as I, nor you as you, and yet together, rising and falling, soft and peaceful, hard and ranging, a dance we only dimly see to music we but faintly hear, together and forever. And if all this were so, if God were like the ocean, and each of us like rain and mist, would my heart not break at losing you? Could the ocean contain my tears? The Kaddish is on page 606. Yitkadal v'yitkadash shmei rabba v'yamad divrach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei v'chayachon v'yomechon ובחיי דוחו בית ישראל, בעגלה ובזמן קריב ואמרו, אמן. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם עולמי עמיה. יתברך, ישתבח, יתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא, ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתהלל שמי דקודשה, בריחו. לאלה ולאלה מכל ברכתה ושירתה, תושפחתה ונחמתה, ודאמירן בעלמה ואמרו אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה, וחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל, ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל, ואמרו אמן. As we come to Ne'ilah, our final service, we're going to open the Ark. It's traditional to have the Ark open during Ne'ilah. Some people may choose to stand the whole time. You don't have to, but we want to give you opportunity right now for a few moments, if you want, to go up to the Ark, individuals, as a family, to bless each other as a family, to meditate at the open Ark. We'll have a few moments, and if during the service you want to come up on the bima too, that's okay.